Hi, my name is Aaron Carl Fernandez, one of the co-authors of this paper, Deep Wrapping Character Level Neural Models in Automated Rap Lyrics Composition. I am a graduate student of Master's of Science in Computer Science in Mapua University, Manila, Philippines, and we did this work as a research project for a pattern recognition class under Dr. Madavi Devaraj. Having said that, all authors have equal contribution to this work. For abstract, dope, twerk, yolo, these are just some of the words that originated from rap music which made into the Oxford Dictionary. Rap lyrics break the traditional structure of English, making use of shortened and invented words to create rhythmic lines and inject informality, humor, and attitude in the music. So in this paper, we attack this domain on a computational perspective by implementing deep learning models that could forge rap lyrics through unsupervised character prediction. Our work employed novel recurrent neural networks for the task at hand and showed that this can emulate human creativity in rap lyrics composition based on qualitative analysis, rhythmic density score, and Turing test performed on computer science students. So rap lyrics are often stigmatized as offensive, profane, and inappropriate. These are usually heavily laced with words that belong to the semantic field of sex, drugs, and discrimination. So because of these, some sections of the society consider rap as a dishonorable music genre that should be avoided because of the language. So to justify our inclination on this domain for scholastic reasons, William Shakespeare, whom has been credited by the Oxford English Dictionary for coining up to 2,000 words, is found to be outvoted by most modern-day rappers such as Aesop Rock, which has 7,392 unique words under his belt. So Matt Daniels, a journalist from The Pudding, published a remarkable visualization of unique words most modern rappers have invented and compared these to prolific writers such as William Shakespeare and Herman Melville. So Aesop Rock outnumbered all the modern rappers analyzed, including Shakespeare and Melville. So in terms of unique words invented, Aesop Rock coined up to 7,392 unique words compared to Shakespeare, whom only had 5,170, and Herman Melville's Moby Dick, whom only had 6,022. So this insinuates that rap lyrics have larger vocabulary than the English literature. So as a graduate student of computer science, we ask, how can we build an artificial intelligence that can come up with a vocabulary of such magnitude? So this question led us to deep learning, a subset of artificial intelligence that can generate music, text, and motion capture using multi-layered artificial neural networks. Artificial neural networks, specifically recurrent neural networks, have an internal memory that maintains previously calculated results, allowing information to persist. So we investigate the automatic composition of rap lyrics on different recurrent neural network architectures and assess its quality through cross-entropy laws, rhyme density score, and human evaluation. So rhyme is considered as an important characteristic feature of rap lyrics, but in this work we put more weight on the merit of how close machines can emulate human writing. So our language model first finds some good default seed strings in the training corpus. This is done heuristically by splitting the data per line and creating a random sample of 200 unique lines from it, after which we only take the top quartile of this random sample based on each line's length for the reason of viewing longer lines as a more decent seed string. Then each character in the training corpus is tokenized, preserving the original letter case of the letter tokens and sorting it in a descending order according to how common it appears. The seed strings and character tokens are both preserved as meta models to be used during the rap lyrics generation. So then the training data is converted into a vector of integer numbers using the character tokens. The resultant data vector is reformatted into input and target sequences, which what will be fed into the recurrent neural network. So the target sequences are configured to have only one time step ahead of the input sequences to force the algorithm to make predictions one character at a time. The reformatting starts by taking strips of the input and target data vectors at an interval of 25 characters and cutting the resulting strips into 50 character sequences, after which the resulting sequences are stacked all together. The resulting data is then again reformatted so that the first sequence in the batch picks up exactly where the sequence in the batch left off, because the recurrent neural network itself does not reset between batches in a stateful model. So finally, the target data is embedded with an extra axis to work with the sparse categorical cross-entropy loss function, which is what will be used to evaluate the training of the recurrent neural network. So once the neural network is fully trained, an initial seed is picked out randomly and transformed into a vector of integer numbers using the preserved metal model generated earlier. So the succeeding character tokens with the maximum probability are then predicted and appended to the vector one at a time. So the character token prediction employs a temperature parameter which value is used to divide the natural logarithm of the probability's array to smoothen or sharpen it. So the intuition behind this is that a lower temperature value dictates a more conservative rap lyrics generation, while a higher will be more creative and diverse at the cost of more mistakes. So this prediction iterates depending on the length of rap lyrics to be generated, which is specified by the user. So once finished, the resulting integer vector is the tokenized, forging a new set of rap lyrics. For this project, we tested our algorithm on three recurrent neural network architectures, namely a plain recurrent neural network, a long short-term memory, and a gated recurrent unit. So to evaluate the quality of our models, first we turn to Shannon's coding theorem, wherein the minimum space we can compress the information in song lyrics is given by the entropy of the distribution over the lyric space. This cannot be computed directly, so as an alternative, its approximation by using the language model to predict a set of lyrics it has not seen before can be used. This approximation is called the cross-entropy measure, specifically the sparse categorical cross-entropy, which is a multi-class logarithmic loss that measures the dissimilarity between the target distribution and the predicted distribution. Secondly, rhyme density is a quantitative measure of the technical quality of rap lyrics from a rhyming perspective. It is simply formulated as the average length of the longest rhyme per word. Finally, we opt to Turing test to validate if the rap lyrics or machine learning models composed can be passed off as being written by a human. So we sampled our lyrics to 30 computer science students of Papua University of 2 were at the doctorate level, 7 were at the master's level, and 22 were undergraduates. All participants were informed that the test was for a machine learning project to get a more consensus evaluation. We also asked the participants if they are familiar with rap lyrics, to which 13 responded yes and 17 responded no. The participants were given 3 sets of tests, which were for low, medium, and high diversity set of generated lyrics. Each set has a 8-6 bar rap lyrics, of which 6 were generated from our models, 1 generated from deepbeat.org, and an actual human-written rap lyric taken from ohhla.com. The participants were asked to make a binary decision about the source of the rap lyrics, which corresponds for each lyric perceived as human by the participant. We collected 4,799 rap lyrics from the original Hip Hop Rap Lyrics Archive or ULA.com. The corpus was cleaned by stripping all HTML tags, metadata like artist name, song name, album name, intro, a chorus, repeat 2 times, and etc., and white spaces between lines. We also manually normalized the data to filter out any malformed metadata in non-English songs, which yielded 696,787 lyric lines amounting to a 27.1 MB file. So we referred to this corpus as data set large. But then we hypothesized that the vast lyrical diversity among the rap lyrics collected may degrade the quality of the generated rap lyrics in terms of rhyme density. So we are also interested to examine the performance of the recurrent neural network architectures discussed above on a smaller data set and see the disparity compared to a larger data set. So we created another corpus concentrated on the songs of 3 rap artists, namely Notorious, B.I.G., Fabulous, and Lil Wayne, as these are the rappers identified in our reviewed literatures who attained the best rhyme scores. So this brought in 42,918 lyric lines in a 1.8 MB file, which we will refer to as a dataset small. We tried different hyperparameter settings on the plain recurrent neural network model first, and we found that three hidden layers with 512 neurons each optimized by Adam optimizer with a learning rate of 0.0001 may work best for the task at hand. So we applied these same hyperparameter settings on all the recurrent neural network models and on both dataset large and dataset small to get a fair judgment on their performances for this experiment. So we trained all models on a 12 gig Tesla K80 for 400 epochs, but with an early stopping rule if there is no loss improvement for 5 epochs on dataset small and 3 epochs on dataset large. But due to the explicit nature of rap lyrics, including the generated rap lyrics of our machine learning models, we decided not to include the samples in this presentation as a respect to all the international experts and our colleagues in this conference. Instead, we will focus on the findings during the training of our models as well as the quality and the result of the Turing test. This table presents the actual training time clock by our RNN models on both datasets. So as you can see clearly, plain recurrent neural networks converge the fastest, taking only almost 2 hours to train on a 1.8 MB dataset and 15 hours on the larger dataset of 27.1 MB. Having said that, it was the worst performer on both datasets in terms of cross-entropy loss. So the disparity in the runtimes of LSTM and GRU on both datasets suggests that GRU trains faster than LSTM on small dataset but can be outrun by the latter on a larger dataset. However, this claim is still refutable as a more thorough experiment concentrated on this facet is required to make such conclusive assertion. So in terms of training quality, the shape of the training curves in figure 1 indicate that the learning rate employed was just about right on all RNN models, but scaling it down a little could have improved the training. So GRU outperformed LSTM and plain recurrent neural networks on both datasets, although the performance of LSTM is not far off GRU. We generated 116 bar versus of medium diversity for each of the RNN models and on both datasets, we considered one bar as equivalent to one line. We also used the RAM analyzer tool developed by Hirji and Brown on their paper to analyze the RAM densities of our generated rap lyrics. This is presented on table 3, and as shown, our generated rap lyrics suffered from poor RAM density score, which is distant to what DeepBeat had achieve and did not even reach the threshold of human rappers such as MC Hammer and Ice Cube, who are considered as the rappers who had the lowest rhyme densities. This is expected as we did not consider rhymes programmatically. We only hypothesized that our generated rap lyrics would inherit the rhyme densities of our corpus, which were 0.28 for dataset large and 0.32 on datasets. So this figure shows that DeepBeat's generated rap lyrics attained the highest score, being perceived as humanly written by 71% of the total participants not familiar with rap lyrics. It even outperformed the real human written lyrics by one vote. So this was almost matched by the LSTM model trained on the dataset small, which achieved the best human evaluation out of all our trained models, receiving 67% and 53% of the participants whom are acquainted and not accustomed to rap lyrics respectively. As a summary, we have investigated the performance of plain recurrent neural network LSTM and GRU on the domain of automated rap lyrics composition at the character level on a small and medium-sized dataset. Plain RNN converged fastest but obtained the worst cross-entropy loss. GRU outperformed both RNN and LSTM in terms of training quality but was the lowest to train on a medium-sized dataset, taking more than 3 days to converge. Having said that, it trained 25% faster than LSTM on a smaller dataset. This suggests that the convergence of LSTM and GRU may depend on the dataset size. However, this assertion demands a more thorough and concentrated investigation. All RNN models on both datasets learn the basic syntax sentence structure of a human written rap lyric even when built at the character level model. Our machine generated rap lyrics convinced a significant number of computer science students into thinking that it was written by a human rapper based on the Turing test performed, although it suffered low rhyme density as it was not considered programmatically. Finally, a potential extension of this work is the incorporation of rhymes and intelligibility in the algorithm to generate a more rhythmic and coherent rap lyric. A hypothetical solution is to generate the rap lines at the character level and develop an algorithm that will weave the generated rap lines into a rap verse based on its accidence and rhyme density score. The insistence of initially constructing the rap lyrics at the character level is due to its offbeat structure and unorthodox vocabulary, which is assumed difficult if built on a word level. So thank you for the organizers of this conference. Also, thank you for the international experts who graced their presence to make this conference successful, and to our fellow colleagues as well for sharing their work and taking some time to learn about ours as well. From Manila, Philippines, thank you.